I think everyone has an interest in the oceans. We all came from the sea initially. We are creatures that evolved in the oceans. We carry the oceans around inside us in a way. I grew up in Wick in the far north of Scotland, and in the middle of the 19th century, Wick was the biggest fishing port in the world. All of that had gone by the time I grew up. So I was always felt a connection between people and the sea. My name is Callum Roberts, and I'm Professor of Marine Conservation in the Environment Department at the University of York. My research is about looking at the ways in which people influence the oceans. The reason that oceans are changing around us so rapidly is, simply put, us. It's the increase in human population size and the rapidly accelerating demand for energy. And the three biggest impacts affecting the oceans today are overfishing, climate change, and pollution. We've seen progressively the elimination of many species that were formerly common. We're seeing the emergence of some serious problems, such as plastic pollution, where huge rafts of plastic are beginning to accumulate in the middle of the oceans. And so I've been looking at the way in which these three great forces interact to influence life in the sea. We're here in Whitby, which is on the Yorkshire coast. And Whitby has for a long time been a major fishing port, which was very active in the 19th century. So in the past, if you went out here with a little boat, you would be able to catch 17 times more fish than we do today for the same effort. It's easy to miss what's going on in the sea because it's out of sight, out of mind. Well, the first stage of recovery of the oceans is to recognize that we do have a problem out here and we need to change the way that we're exploiting the sea. The old fisheries, which used to be dominated by cod and haddock and whiting, those have gone into a terminal decline. So the fishing industry here is a fraction of what it used to be. I think that the problems of the marine environment in general are seen in microcosm here in this town. My research has had an impact already in some ways, in that the research that we did in York has led to the creation of a network of six very large marine protected areas in the mid-Atlantic. They were established in 2010. They cover an area of something like 500,000 square kilometers, which is a lot bigger than the size of the United Kingdom. So that's something I'm really proud of. One legacy that I would really like to see from my research is a much greater amount of protection for the oceans. Some of the work that we have done has shown how if we protect something like a third of the oceans from exploitation, we can maximize the benefits that we get across a whole range of things, from conservation to tourism to fisheries. At the moment, only about 2% of the sea is given any form of protection. Bringing it up to 30% is something which is possible. And I hope it will happen in my lifetime.